Good evening, everyone. This is Roman, and I'm making another video vlog regarding data recovery and different models of hard drives. This is an educational video, and please do not try this at home if you're not sure what you're doing, especially with the drives that you need the data from and that have failed with either mechanical issue or logical type of issues. If it's clicking or if it has some kind of noise, please set it aside and let the professionals deal with it. And today I would like to show you guys one of the drives that actually the model of the drive, which is a Seagate drive, but this particular model comes to us a lot, and this model came out probably about 2 years ago, and those particular models tend to fail a lot, and they are external portable hard drives which are inside of the enclosure, and the enclosure for them, I will show you just an example, looks like this. That's a Seagate portable USB 3.0 2.5 inch hard drive, and this is inside of the enclosure right now. It's basically those drives, they tend to fail, especially if they're dropped or hit by accident. If you drop them on the floor by accident, or you just hit the USB cable while it's plugged in, or move it fast so that it just starts to fail right away and makes some kind of noise. And those models are Seagate external portable drives, backup plus slim. So they're slim Seagate backup plus models, and that's an external enclosure for this drive. And when we open this drive to pull out the actual hard drive, when we open the enclosure, this is the drive that's located in that enclosure. It's a Seagate, which is a Rosewood family of Seagates, and a lot of technicians who are actually watching this video, they have dealt a lot with those drives, specifically this model, for at least already 2 years, maybe a little bit even more than that, when those drives actually went into the production and eventually got purchased and then started failing eventually. So this particular drive was actually made in 2016. So 4 years ago, when those drives went on the market, originally this particular enclosure contained Samsung hard drives, but Seagate purchased Samsung a division of those external portable drives, and actually eventually they transitioned them into Seagate's. So they were originally Samsung drives, different model Samsung drive, which were actually more favorable for the data recovery compared to those particular ones which are Rosewood family of Seagate's. And it's called a mobile, as you can see, it's called mobile hard HDD, mobile hard drive. And they come in two different sizes. They're either 1 terabyte or 2 terabytes. So this particular one is a 2 terabyte. And usually, as an educational video right now, I will open it for you and just show you what's inside of the drive, inside of it, how it looks inside. And I already turned it on before, and it's making really bad noise. And I already know this because the customer said it was dropped and it was making really bad noises. So I plugged it in when I got it to do diagnostics, and it is making really bad noise. So the issue with those particular drives, which are really complicated to recover, it has this sticker that Seagate puts on to cover the actual case, top cover of this drive, which is removable if you unscrew the screws, and it needs a specific 5-point screwdriver, which is a security type of screwdriver for precision work. And I have the whole set here, and you can actually, I'm not sure if you can find exactly this one, but I have a Radio Shack, if you remember Radio Shack stores, which have went out of business a long time ago. And I had this set for a while, and it has different screw tips for the, different tips for actual screwdriver. And as you can see, the screwdriver looks like this and comes with a bunch of different tips and tip ends that you insert into the slot here, and then you put the those tips in the actual slot and you unscrew it and pull out the actual tip, so it's removable like this, and you pull out the tip and replace with a different tip, the one that's compatible to your screw. So in order to actually pull this drive, diagnose it internally, it's really a time-consuming process, but I'll do it for you to so that you see, guys see what engineers have to do every day when they receive those models in their lab. And they have to remove the sticker, which is basically, it's a top sticker which covers the entire top cover where the screws are located, because the screws are here, and when I remove the sticker you'll see where they are. And it also has a circuit board right here, and as you can see, since it was inside of the enclosure, they put this black tape, black removable type of tape on the PCB board, which you can also remove if you need to actually work with a remove or just do any type of work with the actual PCB board. So it's just basically the problem with them, which a lot of engineers hate, is that to remove those stickers from this drive, which is covered in them. So as you can see, that was a sticker right here. It was I just removed it, and now you can see the whole PCB circuit board right here. So now the most kind of not a difficult part, but it's just part where you have to remove that particular top sticker with a label. I mean, it's basically a label which contains all the information such as model, part number, and other important information, serial number, capacity, and manufacturing date, date of manufacture. So basically you have to remove that sticker in order to gain access to the top cover, which covers the internal parts of the drive, which are heads and actuator and platters. So you basically remove it like this, and it has, as you can see, each side is covered with that sticker. So you have to it's not really complicated, but it takes some time, especially when you get a lot of those drives in the same day, to diagnose them and remove this label from the top cover. So that's basically what will be happening right now. I will remove it, and as you can see, this is top cover right here already. You can see it, and you just pull it apart, the label off. It's kind of glued to the top cover, and just gently remove it, because some customers would like to have it back to know what drive it is, because if you lose it you would not know what type of drive it is unless it's working. When you plug it in into computer, and you will see that it is like a 2 terabyte what it is from the label. So without the label it's hard to say what model it is, and it's very important. But just as an educational video for you guys, if you ever tend to have this kind of model, please, especially for engineers, if you're gonna send it out to data recovery companies for the engineers to work on it, do not remove this label. If you remove it, put it back at least, and just put a some kind of tape. You can use regular white office white tape and just put it back, because engineers would not specifically know. I mean, I can tell from my experience what it is, but I'm not gonna be sure if it's a 1 terabyte or 2 terabyte, and engineers will need this label for donor parts which they will need to get in order for them to successfully attempt the recovery, because without the labels they have, each drive is unique, it has unique characteristics, part number, serial number, which has to be similar for the parts that the engineers have to find in order to successfully attempt the recovery. So it's important for you guys, if you ever deal with those types of drives that have this kind of label attached to the top cover, please, if you decide to remove it, just because a lot of people want to open it up, open the drive up and see what's inside, which is not recommended at all. It's just gonna make your chances of the recovery really kind of small in terms of actual procedures, because sometimes people just would not know what. When they take the cover off, they just decide to move the heads inside and touch the platters with their fingers, which is not a good idea. So it's really important. Even if you have this kind of drive right now, you already done this type of procedure. When you remove the label, but you actually open the drive and set it aside and you don't have the label, it's really going to be difficult to even attempt the recovery without knowing the parameters of the actual drive without the label. So it's important to have this label attached if you guys remove it. So, but please do not remove it anyway. Just if you have a bad noise on the drive, just set it aside and call the professionals. It's really important so they can take care of it. And basically